How are you doing, beautiful souls? It is your sister at heart. My name is Princess Yanja, and I am here again with another motivational soul healing video. If you're coming for the first time, do press the subscribe button down below and press the notification bell so that you will be notified every time when I upload a new video. So today's video, we are talking about how to raise the bar. How to make sure that we are vibrating in a high frequency of vibration that is going to also attract high vibrational happenings and events, opportunities and situations in our lives. So without wasting any more of your time, let's just go straight to today's video. Okay, the importance of company in your life plays a huge role. The type of people that you spend most of your time with means that you are definitely going to operate from the similar experiences of life, similar happenings of life, similar of energy fields that you're vibrating from with the people that you tend to spend a lot of time with. So I do strongly believe that our auras or our energy fields, they are almost similar like a sponge. It's like SpongeBob, but like a sponge. The reason why I'm saying that is because a sponge can actually absorb water and hold it in, meaning that water affected, then it becomes heavy, then it becomes wet until you squeeze it out, meaning that is detoxing it out, and it remains the sponge that we know it to be in its neutral, natural state. I do believe that our energy fields, our aura, as the energy itself, works exactly the same. The type of people that you allow in your space, inside your inner cycle, they have a huge influence over your life. If they are the type of people who are low vibrational themselves, they are much likely to turn you into a low vibrational being, even if you don't participate in the actions that they do that make them to be low vibrational beings. If you allow people to come into your spaces and gossip about other people and talk bad about other people and talk down on other people that you might know or not know of, but the fact that you accommodate such behavior, you accommodate people to feel it is okay to come in your space and dump all these low vibrational actions, you are also going to get affected and have low vibrational energy yourself. Another important part of taking charge of your life and controlling being the one who vibrates higher is to make sure, by all means, that you do not find yourself putting a hand, trying to help people who are going through their karma. There are always things and hints that are a giveaway to us that can give us the information we need if we are to help a person or not. I do know, Uguti, most people who are empathetic, people who are the chosen ones, people who feel sorry for other people, who always want to be of service to other people, they tend to put their own intuition behind. They betray their own gut feeling and help people they know they're not supposed to help. But because they feel so sympathetic towards people most of the time, their sympathy works against their favor. And you find yourself participating in people's lives with low vibrational energies, and you help them to be even more low vibrational. You cannot help somebody, for an example, that have been working for years, and they still borrow money to go to work till this day. It means this person needs to learn discipline. They need to learn to take their job seriously. Because if you do not prioritize how you get to work, you expect other people to prioritize it on your behalf and give you what you need for you to get to work, only for you to earn a living that's going to be spent by yourself for your needs and those that are close to you. When you come and help somebody like that, you are prolonging the problem. We cannot shy away from the fact that there are people who are low vibrational, and these things are seen in their day-to-day lives. We can see how they behave, how they treat their money, how they treat people who are next to them, whether they are partners, whether they are families. This becomes like so clear for us to see. So if you know all that information and you still choose to be of service and help somebody who does not help themselves, you are attracting their low vibrational energy and you are bringing it to you. There are certain individuals that you are going to help and disturb the karma that they were going through. and they will never learn the lesson. And the consequences of their actions is going to fall down either to their children or those who are going to suffer who are next to them. And chances are yourself as well, because you are in their inner cycle and you are lending a hand. The reason why I'm saying this is because we need to go back to an understanding, Yoguti, even money is currency and currency is energy. So when you exchange energy with somebody who does not give you anything valuable back, they're going to definitely exchange their low vibrational energy. They're gonna swipe with you something that is low vibrational than what you might have provided them, because you decided to be in the space of somebody you have no business being in the space of, helping people who are not willing to help themselves, helping people who are happy being the victims of the situations, helping people who do not want to see their lives for what they truly are. They are happy with being the people that they are because they are not willing to change. Because you know a person is the person you think they are or what they say they are based on what they do on a daily basis, on a monthly basis. Every time when you get paid, you can't prioritize that you have to get to work the following month. Do not find yourself in a situation where you are now pointing a finger at other people's weaknesses and making it a day-to-day thing that you do. You find pleasure every time when you don't have anything to do. You gotta discuss other people's weaknesses. That shows to yourself that your life itself does not excite you. You have enough time in your hands to discuss about other people's weaknesses. The only time you need to know anything about other people's weaknesses is when you're learning them so you can avoid them. So that you can make sure that if they are weak or they are low, and I'm not to find myself there. But spending time talking about it, spending time discussing about it, coming together with other certain people to discuss such issues, it is also pulling you down to being a low vibrational person. The only weaknesses and the shortcomings that you should always find yourself talking about and investing your time and energy on are your own, for the benefit of changing them for the better. Nurse your trauma. Learn to nurse the wounds of your trauma yourself. It is also important to make sure that you are aware of your state of being. It is okay not to be okay. As human beings, I think we have come to learn that as humans, we go through different phases of life where there will be time where we are extremely happy, sometimes even for no reason. Like we have literally nothing to point at and say, I'm happy because something great have happened in my life. But you feel inside yourself that I'm actually feeling great about myself. That's a good thing. But then there will come a time where also the opposite applies, where you just feel down, you feel sad, you feel drained, you start thinking about maybe things of the past that might have passed and that might have happened and which they were unfortunate. And you feel sad, yeah, like you are reliving that experience. Also, it's human nature. But then pay attention when now the painful events and situations of the past, or good events even of the past, are now hindering your growth. They are now working as stoppers and blockages that are blocking you from living your day-to-day life. They are blocking you from living in the present. Every time when you open your mind and talk about your life and how great or bad your life is, you always refer to the things of the past. If you are a type of a person who speaks of the past the most, more than you speak of the future or the present, that means that you are going through some unhealed traumas or wounds that are within you spiritually that needs attention. They need attention. They need to be taken care of. They need to be healed. So you need to be aware of yourself, nurse your wounds, allow yourself to agree that things did happen and they didn't have to happen. And you do not have to pretend as if they did not happen, because then they are going to consume you even more. But the more you accept the truth, as ugly as it might have been, and see the people who might have participated in hurting you, in harming you, in backlashing on you, in talking bad about you, in trying to kill your reputation, and people who did all the horrible things when they didn't have to do them. You need to accept that it did happen. Sometimes we become in denial that painful things took place because they're just too painful. We are okay with pretending as if they did not happen, but they will lower your vibration. they will make sure ukuthi they attract more problems in your life, more problematic people in your life. They're going to attract unnecessary events that are going to take place and cause you situations that can leave you in debt for no absolutely no reason at all, other than the fact that you have unhealed trauma that you haven't really realized for what it truly is, so that you can heal it. It is important to do self-introspection, sit by yourself, ask yourself some certain questions. If you go back in the past, go back in the past because you're looking for something to fix, not because you're living in the past. The fifth thing that I want to also talk about that is truly important is to make sure that on a daily basis, you are doing something that is bringing you closer to achieving your goals. Yes, I said it, on a daily basis. You gotta do something crazy. You gotta do something that is out of your comfort zone. You gotta take a chance and make a conversation with the person that you just admire so much, but you fear that maybe you're gonna come across and embarrass yourself. You gotta come out of your comfort zone as much as you can. Each and every week should end when you have done something that was really scary. That's how you come closer into doing greater things in life. That's how you come closer into discovering yourself and your potential and your abilities, because you do not know yourself the way you think you do until you put yourself in situations that are truly scary and are truly challenging. Only then you will discover that actually there is more to me than just what I've been pretending there is. And the more you do things that are outside of your comfort zone, the more you're going to feel excited. The adrenaline that you're going to feel within you, it's going to want to make you do more of things that are scary. You're going to start facing more of your fears, because people who have endless number of fears, they have fears that they've had since they were kids. They've never put themselves in situations where they get to face their fears. You are a low vibrational being because you're not living up to your highest potential, because you operate from a place of fear. If you go to the energy fields chart or board, you'll see that fear is among the lowest vibrational frequencies. But if you want to vibrate higher, you gotta have things such as love, kindness, you know, excitement, the feeling of acceptance, even if it's just self-acceptance, etc. So make sure, ubutike, no matter what you do, do something great. Then what comes after is that you need to be a type of a person who is willing to care less about who thinks and says what about you, as long as you know that that is not who you are, that's not what you are about, that's not how you operate, and it is none of your business what they think about you, whether they like you or not. I love this thing that they say in my language, ukuthi awuyona imali so ngeke uzuthandwe abantu bonke. Only money is loved by everybody. But if you are not money, for as long as you are not money, expect that there are people who are going to dislike you. And people who dislike you are people who have their own issues, and you are a representation of the issues they have. For as long as you know you're not going around messing around with people's lives, messing around with people's bags, messing around with people's names or reputation, if you know that you know nothing about this person, you didn't do anything to this person, and they choose that they dislike you, it should be a sign to you that you're doing good. When you are liked and loved by everybody, it means you have no backbone. You don't speak your mind, you don't say what you mean, and you don't mean what you say. You are always in a space where you are saying things to people that they need to hear. That on its own is a red flag. I wouldn't befriend anyone who is loved by everybody. I wouldn't want to be close to anyone who is adored by everybody. Not even one person questions them. Not even one person wants to go against them. Not even one person. Nanja, you are untouchable. You are this mighty, powerful being. It's human nature to have people who will not like you. It shows, ukuthi, you are rising the bar of your energy field. You are operating from a space where they still imagine themselves operating from. They still wish they can operate from. Even better when you choose not to participate in their slurs, when they throw shade, when they try to talk down on you, when they try to say things at your workplace so they can get you fired, they are working overtime to try and tarnish your name and throw you off the bus. And you choose to remain in your lane, to remain in your space. You do not even confront these people. You just do what you have to do when you have to do it, and you leave. When you do that, you are protecting your energy and you are remaining in a high frequency energy. Of course, you're not going to always take people's bad behavior at all times without acting or saying anything. There'll come a time where you also gotta know, I gotta fight my battles. I gotta talk back to this person and make them aware. You can try what you're doing, but you're not gonna win or whatever. But make sure they don't live or rent free in your mind. People who mistreat you should not have so much time in your mind. They should not stay in your mind like that. So maybe if they do something or say something shady, you say it back, so that when you leave that particular space, you don't have to think about them, because you gave them their own taste of their medicine as well, and you left it there. Don't go home and find yourself thinking about situations that might have been horrible at work on that day, because now you're upsetting the home time because of the things that happened in a workspace. You're going to get angry on the following day. Right now, the family needs you as the mother or as the father, or you need yourself. Upgrade your boundaries at all times. High vibrational beings, they make sure that they upgrade their boundaries at all times, all the time. How do you do that? People who have access to you should know how to behave in your space. There are things that are just unacceptable. Don't laugh. Don't laugh at the jokes that are low-key insulting you, because you know this is an insult and it's dressed in a joke. Don't entertain that. That's how you raise the bar of your frequency. That's how you create healthy boundaries. Don't allow people to think they can mistreat you, disappear for a week or a month or a year, and then they come back with, hey, stranger, how are you doing? Thinking that time have rubbed off, or time have erased everything that might have done before they disappeared. No, you did what you did and you disappeared. I haven't forgotten about it. I'd be a fool to forget about how you mistreated people, or how you mistreated me, or what you did that was low vibrational last time. Now that you think that a year has passed, you think that I've forgotten. I haven't forgotten about what you've done. It's either people are going to be accountable in your space, take accountability, apologize if you have to, acknowledge that how you left was not normal, talk about it, even if you don't want to apologize, explain yourself so that we can get to see what space do I get to place you in my personal space, because energy means a lot. You know, energy, that's how strong energy is. You might have never had an argument with somebody, but when somebody have low vibrational thoughts about you, you can feel that we are not buddies with this person. We are not that close with this person. We never really fought, but like we are not vibing. That's the power of energy. That's how powerful energy is. So make sure that you protect your energy at all times from people who might show signs of being low vibrational, even if it includes people who don't love themselves. People who don't love themselves, there is no way they're going to know how to love anybody else. People who do not respect themselves, don't expect them to respect you. People who don't even love their own spaces, don't think they're going to come and respect and love your space. So sometimes low vibrational people are not going to do anything harmful to us, but how they treat themselves is a sign of what we need to expect if we decide to bring them close and open doors for them so that they can be part of our inner cycles. Because that's what we need to expect as well in the near future, because those are the things they will do to you or in your space, the things that they do to themselves currently. Upgrading your boundaries include things like deleting some certain people from your phone numbers or your phone book that are no longer necessary. People who might have done some shady business before and they didn't come and say, you know, something like this happened. What? How do we move forward now? How do we fix this? Like, I did this for these reasons. People who do not have any conversations with you, but they know everything that you do. They check on everything that you post. They don't have any way of starting a conversation with you. You also don't know even if you are to start a conversation, which part you will take in starting a conversation with them. You're not that close with that person. How come they have so much access over what is happening over your life? Not everybody who sees you and congratulates you and clap their hands for you are really that happy for you. They're going to think you think that you are all that. They're going to say things like, you think you are better than everybody. well, maybe that's what I want to do. Maybe I really want to be better than everybody that I've been knowing from where I'm coming from, so that maybe there will be somebody who will see the good that I do and they will be motivated and inspired to also want to do better for themselves, for their families, for their lives, for their future children or families, if they choose they want to have the families of their own one day. Sometimes when you are the only person who's doing the right thing, you start feeling unsettled when everybody else is against you. But it is better to be one person who's doing the right thing than to be one of the 10 people who are doing the wrong thing. Because eventually the truth will come out and everybody else will know who's who. Do you know the saying that they always say when they say, now that I'm grown, I'm not really like quoting it exactly how it is, but it goes along the lines of, now that I'm grown, I am now understanding better why the distant aunt was distant. So children, we will grow up seeing the nature of families and our structures, and there's always going to be that one aunt or uncle who's just distanced from the family because they know things or they have said things that in the family that they might have been, you know, hidden, or things that people don't want to fix. They are happy with the dysfunctional life that they're living as a family. So there's always going to be that one family member who distances themselves and starts something of their own afar. So eventually you grow up as a kid and you get to understand why the aunt was distant, because now you see the things and the people for what they truly are. So it is very important to make sure you upgrade your boundaries at all times. Don't act like you are kind. Be kind. You cannot rob or fool energy. Language is a very primitive thing that we use to communicate and make a comprehension among each other to make sense of this life that we live in. But also, energy does not lie. You might sweet talk people, you might show kindness, you might do beautiful things for people, and only to find that you are only operating from a place of ego. You don't really help or show that you are helping because you care about other people's wellness. It's your ego that is looking for something to be meaningful. It is looking for something that you can do that can boost your sense of identity, that can boost your self of acceptance and feeling of importance, of which is also not a bad thing, because if you want to boost how you feel about yourself in expense of helping someone else, well, someone is getting helped. But then energy does not lie. If you really don't give because you are giving from your heart of wanting to give, it's something that you want to do. It has nothing to do with your ego. You don't care whether you are recognized or not. Then you are definitely going to bear the fruits energetically. Your energy is going to rise. You can do things as two people that are similar, but operating from different energy fields. And only one person is going to receive back the high frequency of energy. The person who's giving wholeheartedly without expecting anything in return, or somebody who is not operating from a place of ego. Somebody who's operating from a place of ego might gain celebrity, they might gain the exposure, the attention that they're looking for and seeking for, because chances are maybe they've never really felt enough of themselves. So they will do anything it takes to make sure that they do something that will draw their eyes so that they can hear those encouraging words. And also they will not last long. They will still want to do something more because this thing is broken to the core. The ego itself is overpowering the rest of this person's well-being. And they are unaware that this thing is not them being genuinely the givers that they believe they are. They are just looking for something to smooth the pain that is already within them. But once you have gone through the wounds, when we said on point 4, if not 5, nurse your wounds, nurse your trauma, so that whatever that you do, you're not operating from a low vibrational place of your trauma, but you are doing it wholeheartedly because it is your growth taking you there and making you do the things that you do. Nurse your wounds, be aware of your trauma so that you can be able to show kindness without any motives behind that are hidden. Being kind is going to the energy that you operate from, and you will receive exactly the same energy back to you, because we said energy is like magnet. Whatever that you are within you will multiply and you will attract it back to you. You won't need to chase for it. I hope that this video did find you in a good spirit. If you are new here, I hope you did join the family by pressing the subscribe button. Thank you so much for staying tuned in. Until next time, love and light.